When it comes to your computer and surfing the web, you're probably pretty reliant on your mouse. I know I am. But what if you couldn't use a mouse? And I don't just mean because you needed to plug it in. Welcome to What in the World is WCAG? 2.1 Keyboard Accessible. Keyboard. Everything you can do by clicking with a mouse, tapping on a touchscreen, or using other pointing devices, you should be able to do just using the keyboard. This means you can use keys like Tab to move between buttons and links, Enter to select something, and arrow keys to navigate in drop-down menus or scroll through a page. Note that while this is called keyboard, there are other methods like buttons and sip and puff that use the same basic functionality. No keyboard trap. When using a website, you should be able to move forward and backward through all of the interactive elements, like forms, links, and buttons, without getting stuck on any part of the page. If you can get into a part of a web page using a keyboard, you should be able to get out of it using a keyboard too. And I do mean all interactive elements, from modals to buttons. Some just doesn't cut it. There are circumstances where you want to make a keyboard trap. For example, if the cookie banner requires interaction, you should make a keyboard trap that keeps the focus inside the banner to make it easier for keyboard users. Character key shortcuts. If a website uses keyboard shortcuts that involve letter, number, or symbol characters, like pressing P to print, there should be a way to either turn them off, remap them to include a non-character key, like Control or Alt, or only have them active when that part of the page is focused. This is important because it prevents accidental activation of shortcuts, especially when a user is typing. You've probably experienced this yourself at some point. Keyboard accessible, because not everyone uses a mouse. By the way, there's a video on keyboard navigation in our Don't Be Afraid Of series. It's worth a watch.